My name is Desmond Oathes, and we're at the Veterans Hospital in Palo Alto, California. I work here as well as at Stanford University down the road. I grew up in the San Francisco Bay Area. I moved around quite a bit since then, but back here again. My parents, my mother was a stay-at-home mom, and my dad is a machinist, so he works in a machine shop in the area. I like to hang out with my friends, go to the beach, have big parties and bonfires and things like that at the beach. That was a big one for me. Hiking and being outdoors was something that I've enjoyed from early on and continue to enjoy. I think what we're hoping that with brain stimulation methods we can help people recover from traumatic memories faster. So we're going to try that out in a variety of ways on healthy individuals who learn some new contextual information that they could be that their body could be kind of responsive to, and see if we can nudge that down with brain stimulation. And if that works, that's an awesome model for applying to, say, post-traumatic stress disorder, where people are learning to be afraid of something that they didn't grow up being afraid of, and seeing if we can nudge that circuit kind of back towards health. So I have a bunch of studies that are in a big MRI at Stanford, and then a number of them here at the Veterans Hospital, where we attach a bunch of physiological sensors related to emotion and have people do kind of crazy experiments where they're challenging their memory and seeing if we can benefit people ultimately through behavior training, through brain stimulation, and characterizing the illness better with imaging. The culture is really collaborative, and we have people that are from a variety of training disciplines, which is really fun. We have engineers, MD, psychiatrists, clinical psychologists, and having those people interact I think is really fun and challenges us all in new ways when we get together and try to plan studies.
So I'm done with the kind of like classroom aspect of the whole UCSF thing, and I'm moving on to the research part, the qual part. Okay. So should I touch on like all three of the studies that I worked that are being that you guys are talking about in the letters too?
I'm kind of a late bloomer with a lot of things, so I didn't figure out the importance of kind of doing well in school until I was basically an adult and looking to move out of my parents' house, and then I realized, oh boy, I really need to do something here. When I was in college, I was bitten by the science bug, and I really got into kind of applying methods to that help us quantify things about human behavior that I hadn't really considered before. I'm starting to get some of my own grants where I'm the head investigator and making more of my own decisions with the projects, and some of the people that were mentoring me before have now become more like colleagues.
We got this really cool result the other day where we were looking at the cartilage. Can you think of any ways to try to bring in more vasculature?
I have no idea.
Failure is something I think if you choose a scientific career, you have to really get used to. You fail a lot more than you succeed. And even the most accomplished scientists can tell you many terrible failure stories where they felt like this is the end. Yeah, this is the biggest deal, and this is the thing I needed to make my career. You find other ways. You have to really believe in yourself no matter what kind of criticisms and failures you have. There are a number of hurdles at every step of the career, but if you are passionate about science, I think that there's a way for everybody to kind of connect to that and make that a career. And that happened for me. A lot of my friends are, you know, in the tech industry, as you can imagine, in this area, and they're doing very well financially. They work a lot less hours than I do, but I'm so passionate about the science that, you know, no matter what the hurdles are, I'm just going for it. I've put all my chips in, you know, that I'm going for this career. And so if you're exposed to a few different labs and you get passionate about the scientific questions so much that you don't care about the details of the rest of the lifestyle, I think you should go for it, and I think there's a place for you.